Welcome to the Blazor MultiSelect Dropdown tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to select multiple items in Syncfusion Blazor MultiSelect Dropdown component using checkbox. Enabling a checkbox for each item offers a convenient solution for interaction, allowing selection of multiple items. Now let me open an existing Blazor web app in auto mode. If you want to learn how to create the Blazor web app, check the video link provided in the description below. I have already added the Syncfusion Blazor MultiSelect Dropdown component and bound it to the data source property with vegetables list data. If you want to learn how to add the Blazor MultiSelect Dropdown component to the Blazor app, check the video link provided in the YouTube card above. Let's run the example application. You can see the MultiSelect Dropdown rendered with a placeholder. When I click the dropdown, see the provided list of vegetables. Next, I'll show you how to enable checkboxes in the Blazor MultiSelect Dropdown component. The MultiSelect feature allows users to select multiple values through checkboxes. To enable this functionality, simply add the mode property and set it to checkbox. Look now, when I click the dropdown, you'll notice the MultiSelect Dropdown rendered with checkboxes. I can select and deselect items using the checkboxes as needed. Next, I'll demonstrate how to customize the checkboxes. The MultiSelect component includes built-in support for selecting all list items using the Select All option in the header. To achieve this, set the Show Select All property to true. Look now, by default, the Select All option is visible. Clicking it activates all checkboxes. Similarly, there's an Unselect option that upon clicking, deactivates all checkboxes. If you wish to customize the text displayed for Select All and Unselect, I can use the Select All text and Unselect All text properties respectively. For example, I can set the text to Select All Vegetables for the Select All text property, and unselect all vegetables for the unselect all text property. Look now, you can see the MultiSelect Dropdown component rendered with the provided customized text. Additionally, if you need to limit the number of selected items, I can set the maximum selection length property to 3. As you can see, attempting to enable more than 3 items using checkboxes randomly will not be possible adhering to the specified limit. Please note that upon closing and reopening the dropdown, the selected vegetables are arranged in order. If you prefer to disable reordering, I can set the Enable Selection Order property to false. Look now, upon clicking the dropdown, selecting checkboxes randomly, and closing and reopening the dropdown, notice that the selected order cannot be changed. Next, I'll show you how to enable checkbox grouping in the Blazor MultiSelect Dropdown component. First, for clear understanding purposes, I'll remove the maximum selection length property. To enable checkbox grouping, set the Enable Group checkbox property to true. This allows you to group items within the dropdown using checkboxes. Here, I already arranged the data source items by grouping them with checkbox mode in MultiSelect. Then set the group by property to category in the MultiSelect field settings. This allows you to group the items displayed in the MultiSelect dropdown. It is based on a specific property of your objects. Look now, you can see the MultiSelect dropdown rendered with checkbox grouping. Clicking the checkbox in a group will select all the items grouped under it. Let me summarize what I covered in this video. I showed how to select multiple items using checkboxes, customize checkbox selection order, and limit selected items using checkboxes. Also, I showed how to enable checkbox grouping in Blazor MultiSelect Dropdown component. If you want to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link to see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor products. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.